The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lay down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still water. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will feel no evil. Hello, everybody. I want to thank all of you all that have subscribed to this YouTube page. And if you have not subscribed to this YouTube page, I ask you from the dear of my heart, please hit the like and subscribe button. And I just want to say to you a few words of encouragement that we are going through a pandemic time now, this COVID-19. And I'm asking you to put your confidence and trust in the Lord. And the Lord's going to see us through because he's our shepherd. He's our guide. He's going to lead us through this whole world of trouble. So keep your hands in the hands of the man from Galilee. And guess what? On this page, we got many more to come.
In the field, I will work shirt brave and true. In the fight for the right, I will dare and do. Church, spend my days in thy praise. All thy journey through, let me live close to thee each day. Let me live close to thee. Take my hand, dear Lord, and guide me all along the rugged way. Oh, let me live close to thee. Lord, let me walk and talk with thee, dear Lord, each day. I just want to live close to thee each day. There is a place that I know. And in this place, it had been talked about, there is a son is born, there's a son is given. The governor should be up on his shoulder. He should be called the everlasting father, the prince of peace. This place that I know, it have been prophesied before this child was born. It tells us about a child is born. And in the place that was established is going to be for him. It give us the place that where his law going to begin and where the word of the Lord should go forth from. Just in thy field for the right, I will dare and do spend my days in thy praise. All of my journey through. This place that we're going to talk about is not from hither. It's not from earth. This place that came down, it came down from heaven. I said, this place, it came down from heaven. And there was a virgin. And she gonna bring forth a son. And when she bring forth this son, his name should be called Wonderful Counselor, the Almighty God, the Everlasting Father. Yeah. And when the son, when this child is born, he's gonna save his people from their sin. Y'all get your Bible and notepad together. I will get ready to have a study in God most holy in divine word. Yes, we want to talk about AD 33. I said, we want to talk about AD 33. The Lord Church, the Church of Christ in AD 33. This is so important because this is giving us some history of the Lord Church, the Church of Christ. This church is the only church that you can read about the true history about the Lord Church. And this history that I'm talking about is found in the Bible. It's found in the Word of God. And when we talk about this history, that it come in, and this church is not a earthly vessel in the doctrine that have been placed in the church. The doctrine, the teaching, the organization of the church, all of this came from heaven. So it's not a man-made creed. Man don't have anything to do with this church, because it was sent down from the Father through his Son. And if you look at John chapter 6 and verse 38, the Bible said, Jesus says these words. He said, "For I come me down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him that sent me. And this is the Father's will, which have sent me, that of all which he has given me, I should lose nothing, but should rise it up again in the last day." So Christ said, "I come down to do my Father's will." So Christ is the head. We're going to find out that Christ is the head of the body of this church that came down from heaven. And when we look at the body of Christ, the church, we're going to look at some prophecies about this church before the Son was born. I said, before the Son was born. Now, y'all, let me tell you this. Now, Christ always been here before beginning of time. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, they've been here all the time. But since man fell from grace from God, man had to have a way to get back in the unity of the Father and of the Son. Yes, sir. I said man had to have a way to get back in the unity of the Father and the Son and the Spirit. Since it was man that fell from grace. And you remember in the book of Genesis, when God created man and woman, he made them in his own image, and man had everything that he needed. But since he fell from grace, the Lord had to prepare a way for man to get back into him. Now, and to get back in the unity of the Father and the Son and the Spirit, he had a place prepared, made up for him to come back to the Father. But they got to obey him. Let's get into this. And if you open your Bible here to the book of Isaiah, chapter 2 and verse 2 to 3. Now what we're doing here, we're showing you that the prophecy of the Lord's house is going to be established. And we're showing you the place that where the church is going to be established. Isaiah chapter 2 and verse 2 to 3. It says, "And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mounting of the Lord's house shall be established, and the top of the mountain and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it." Verse 3. "And many people shall go and say, Come ye, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, and to the house of God of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem." Now we're going to read this again, because this is important. Now pay attention to what the word of the Lord is saying. Isaiah 2 and 2. And it shall come to pass in the last day. There's something coming to pass. Well, in the last days. It said the top of the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established. Now it's saying that in the last days that the Lord's house is what gonna be established. Look at that. The Lord's house is gonna be established. Then it says in the top of the mountain, and shall be exalted above all the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. So whenever this place that's gonna be established, all nations shall flow unto it. Unto it. Unto what? The Lord's house. Unto what? The Lord's house. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established, and the top of the mountain shall be exalted and exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. And many people should go and say, come ye, let us go up into the mountain of the Lord's house, to the house of God of Jacob. And we would, and he will teach us of his ways. Now in this house, only in the Lord's house, nowhere else, only in this Lord's house. In the last days, when it come, this house is going where we're gonna get the law of the Lord, and he's gonna teach us of his ways. He's gonna come out of Zion of Jerusalem. It's coming out of the Zion of Jerusalem. Birth three again. And, okay, it said, and many people should go and say, come ye, let us go up into the mountain of the Lord, into the house of the God of Jacob. Yeah. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk well in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. The word of the Lord is coming out of Jerusalem. And at your convenient time, you can read about the same thing in the book of Malachi, chapter 4 and verse 1 to 2. That's the book of Malachi, chapter 4 and verse 1 and 2. But I'm going to read Isaiah one more time, just so that you can get, before we move on. Isaiah said again. Now why I'm repeating this, because we're getting to some nitty gritty here. We're showing you the birthplace, that where the church is coming from. We're showing you that where the church of Christ, hallelujah, is coming from. This is the place that it's coming from. And this place was established in heaven. It didn't come down here from earth. And if you found yourself in a place that was not founded by Christ, one need to examine himself and see, are they going according to the word of God? And it shall come to pass in the last day that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established, and the top of the mountain shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow well unto it. The Bible says, and many people should go and say what? Come ye and let us go up into the mountain of the Lord's house, to the house of the God of Jacob. For what? And he will teach us of his ways, and we will do what? And we will walk in his paths. Where it's coming from? For out of Zion go, and what is law and the way that we're going to learn of his way coming from? It said, for out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord. Where it coming from? Coming, word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Now we know that this place is coming out of Jerusalem. It's there in Jerusalem that where all the people gonna be gathered together, and on and in the place of Jerusalem that where they're gonna begin to learn the way of the Lord. Look at Isaiah chapter 28 and verse 16. I want you to look at Isaiah chapter 28 and verse number 16. What are we talking about? We're talking about AD 33, the coming of the Lord Church out of the city of Jerusalem. Yeah, we're talking about the all nation gonna be together there in this place in Jerusalem. It's where the word of the Lord is coming from. Isaiah 28 and verse 16. The Bible said, truly says the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion for a foundation. This place is laid in Jerusalem out of Zion. It is a foundation. The Bible says, there are no other foundation can be laid than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Therefore, truly saith the Lord, behold, I lay in Zion for what? A foundation, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. He that believeth shall not make haste. This is a sure foundation. What foundation? The one that gonna be coming from Jerusalem. A sure foundation. This is the sure foundation. In this foundation, in this house, well, you must learn the way of the Lord. Notice, in the Lord's house, not somebody else's house. Can't nobody do this but the one that called Lord of Lord and the King of Kings. He the only one can do this. Look at Luke chapter 20 and verse number 17. Luke chapter 20 and verse number 17. And behold, and he beheld them and said, what is this then that is written? The stone which the builder reject, the same is become the head of the corner. Okay, now we see that this house that's going to be established in Jerusalem, that he's going to be the head cornerstone of it. Who? Christ. He talking. He Christ going to be the head cornerstone of what? This church that is, this house that was seen in Isaiah chapter 2 and verse 2. And it should come to pass in the last day that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established. And the top of the mountain shall be seen above the hill. All nations shall flow well unto it, unto what? Into this house. This is the house, the builder that he's talking about. Christ is going to be the builder. And since he's going to be the builder, he's going to be the head cornerstone of the Lord church. Now, I'm going to show you now. Now, since we're talking about AD 33, now I'm going to show you here that man can't do nothing about it. Man can't touch this. Man can't add to it. And man cannot subtract from the teaching that coming out of Jerusalem in the Lord's house. Man can't add, or he can't take away from it. See, Jesus said in the book of Revelation and book of Deuteronomy, he said, if any man should add unto his word, God gonna add unto him the plagues that are written in the book, the words that's coming out of the city of Jerusalem. You better be careful how you saying you're walking in the Lord and you can't even find the place where your organization was established. I know that the Lord Church, the Church of Christ, was established and founded by no other than Christ. And later on, if time permit, we're going to show you from the Bible that Christ is the only one that purchased the church with his own blood. Christ gave his life for his church, not man. He gave his life for the church. The other organization cannot find where they so-called leaders gave their life for their so-called church. They can't find it because it's not there. But in the Lord church, AD 33, we can find out that Christ gave his life for his church. He the only one that died out there on the cross of Calvary. Luke chapter 20 and verse 17. And he beheld them and said, what is this that is written? the stone which the builder reject, the same will become the head of the corner. Now when the church come, he gonna be the head of the corner of the church. Now my question is, who gonna do this? Who gonna do this? Who gonna do this? Psalm chapter 118 verse 22 to 23 to 24 gonna give us the answer to this. I said the book of Psalm chapter 118 verse 22 to 24 gonna give us the answer to this. Look what it said. The stone which the builder reframed is becoming the head of the corner. Look at that. It said, the stone which the builders reframe is become what? The head of the corner. So when this house come, he gonna be the head of the corner. Okay, who doing is this? Who gonna do this? Is Pope Boniface gonna do this? Is the Jehovah Witness gonna do this? Is the modern day saints gonna do this? And all these folks perverting God's word, is they gonna do this? Who gonna do this? This should be the question. Who gonna do this? Because the Lord's house is gonna be established in Jerusalem, and when it come, oh, he's gonna be the head cornerstone of this church. Now look what it says in verse number, I'm going to read this again. I'm going to read all of it. Okay, Psalms 118 verse 22 to 24. We're going to read all of it, okay, and then we'll come back. Okay, this is what it says. The stone which the builder reframed is becoming the head stone of the corner. Hallelujah. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous well in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord made, and we ought to rejoice and be glad in it. In it what? In the day that the coming of the Lord church, and when they're going to be established on this earth, giving every man a chance to be saved from their sin, we ought to rejoice and be glad in it. Why? Because this is the day that the Lord made. Not only did he made it, but this is his doing. This is the Lord's doing. Can anybody show me in the Bible where there is another place in the Bible where the Lord did this for? Can somebody show me in the Bible where the Lord did this for another place? We're talking about AD 33, the coming of the Lord church, the founding place of the Lord church. Where? Out of the city of Jerusalem, in Jerusalem. This the Lord's doing, not mine, not yours. This is the Lord's doing. Therefore, truly says the Lord, behold, I lay in Zion for a foundation, a dry stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. This is a sure foundation. It is a sure foundation. Why? Because it is the Lord's doing. The Lord did this. The Lord did this. And this is the day which the Lord made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. So when you come into the body of Christ, the church of Christ, by the way, he'll believe, repent, confess, and go down there into the water and get your sin washed away and come and live faithful unto the end of the days of your life. You ought to come in the Lord's church rejoicing, shouting for great joy, because you have found the place that where Christ established. You have found the place where Christ gave his life for a church. Come up here in the book of Acts. Run to the New Testament in the book of Acts, chapter 4, verse 10 to 12. Book of Acts, chapter 4, verse 10 to 12. It's going to rehearse what he said here in the book of Psalms, chapter 118, verse 22 to 24. Going to rehearse that us the same thing to let you know this is the sure foundation coming out of the city of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Let us know this is the place. This is the place. Acts, chapter 4, verse 10 to 12. It said, be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel. Hallelujah. that Biden, now who's gonna do this? This is the question. Who's gonna do it? Who's gonna do it? Since it's the Lord's doing, what is this Lord's name that's gonna do this? Okay? In Acts chapter 4, verse 10 to 12. Be it known unto you all, and to all the people of Israel, that by the what? Name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Who's gonna do this? The name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus gonna do this. Our Lord of Lord and King of Kings gonna do this. He gonna be, the reason why he was called Nazareth, because they took them in the city of Nazareth because they wanted to kill him. You need to go back and read the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and you can get more of this history about this Savior we're talking about here. But right now, we're just talking about the established place of the coming of the Lord Church, the Church of Christ. It said, be it known unto you all and to all of the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, look what it said, whom ye crucified. Now, this is very important right here. We don't want to bypass this. I want to tell you this. Who was crucified on the cross to save mankind from their sin? Who was the one that was crucified to save mankind from their sin? Now, this should cause anybody anywhere to stop and put a pause on their button and ask themselves the question, did Pope Boniface die on the cross for my sin? Did the Mormon pause to crucify themselves for me to be in that church? This should be a pause for all of us that said we are in Christ and we can't find where Christ established some of these organizations from. We can't find them in the Bible. So something's wrong somewhere. I just want to pause here because when we read the Bible, we need to stop and think what the scripture is telling us. Not run through it, but listen to what it's saying. Be it known unto all of you, to all of the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ, whom ye crucified, look, whom God raised from the dead. Now let me ask you this question. These churches you going to, I'm not going to use the Pope Boniface because many people in these organizations. Now, let me ask you this. Now, Pope Boniface, he dead, right? He laying somewhere 6 foot in the ground, or he in some kind of mausoleum that have been sealed up, right? Now, have you ever read in the scripture anywhere that, well, the Father came down and raised the Pope Boniface up from the grave? Huh? Have you read, have you found that in the Bible? The Baptist man that said that they established a Baptist church. I'm not ridiculing anyone. I'm just saying, just give us a chance to think now. Where have you read in the Bible that where the Father raised John Calvin from the grave? Have you ever read that where he raised him from the grave? So if he not raised from the grave, he not nobody's savior. He don't have no right to call, you don't have no right to put up an organization in a Baptist name. You don't have that right because this is not the founder place of the church. You can't read that. Some founder place of some church, they come from England. Some come from New York City. Some come from Germany. Some come from Asia. Some come from Timbuktu. They just coming from everywhere. And the Lord ain't you can't find the organization in the word. You can't, but they'll use the Bible. Now, let me say that. Only reason why they had to use the Bible, because they don't have nothing else. If they don't use the Bible, you won't follow them. If they won't say, we telling you what the Bible said, you won't follow them. You got that much sense. But when it comes down to the truth now, We got to see, you need to find out where the final place of the church came from and who established the church and who is the head cornerstone of the church is. We just talking about AD 33, the coming of the Lord church from the city of Jerusalem. See, we get excited in the body of Christ, those that study in the church of Christ. We get excited when we talk about the AD 33, the coming of the Lord church, the founding of the Lord church. And we can go back and get the history from the Bible. We ain't got to go to the shelf. I ain't got to listen to some man call himself preaching in the pulpit. I ain't get it from the Word of God. It's there. It's tell us his teaching. It's tell about his doctrine. It's tell about his pattern. And not only that, but this foundation is a sure foundation. It is a sure foundation. Okay, let me move. I'm getting into the lesson. Let me move on. Okay, go back. Okay, here we go. Acts chapter 14 and 12. Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye have crucified, whom God had raised from the dead, even by him doth this man stand here before you whole. Verse 11. This is a stone which was set in north of your building, which you become the head of the corner. I told you, he said the same thing that Psalm chapter 118 verse 22 to 24 told us, that he is the head cornerstone of the church. Y'all, I just got to read it one more time, because the Bible is speaking for itself. It don't need me to speak for it, but the Word of God is speaking for itself. Being known unto you all and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye had crucified, whom God had raised, whom ye had crucified. Excuse me, I'm getting excited. Let me slow down here. Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him doth this man stand here before you whole. Verse 11. This is the stone which was set in north of your building, which you become the head of the corner. Now listen, since he's the head of the corner, and since he's the head of the building, listen what it said in verse number 12, to let you know that this is the place that coming out of the city of Jerusalem is neither their salvation in any other, for there none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. So we know that if you want to be saved, you got to come into the place that coming out of the city of Jerusalem. Over here in the book of Daniel chapter 2 and verse number 4, I'm feeling pretty good and talking about AD 33, the coming of the Lord church. The Bible tells me over here in the book of Daniel chapter 2 and verse 4-4, the Bible says, in the days of thee, king, shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdom, and it shall stand forever. This kingdom is gonna stand forever, and when this kingdom come, it's not gonna be in the hands of man. The church of Christ is not in the hands of man. Man can't come into the church of Christ and try to put his rule and regulation in the church of Christ. It won't work, because it didn't come from man. It came from Christ. It came from Christ. Christ is the only one that died on that old rugged cross unto give us the plan of salvation. Jesus is the only one that told mankind everywhere, come unto me, all of you that have laid on, and I will give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is meek and my burden is light. You got to come into this kingdom that where Christ gave in light. Well, where it's coming from? It's coming out of the city of Jerusalem. I said, where it's coming from? It's coming from out of the city of Jerusalem. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Y'all, you know, the the Christ gave his life for the church. And this church is coming out of the city of Jerusalem to let you know we're going to still keep in pattern what we talk about. We're going to keep on rehearsing Isaiah chapter 2 and verse 2 to 3. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established, and the top of the mountain shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. And it's there. And many people should go and say, yeah, come ye, and let us go up into the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us of his ways, and out of his ways, and we will walk in his path. For out of Zion should go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Daniel said, and in the days of these kings, shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed. And the kingdom should not be left to other people, but it should break in pieces and consume all of these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. He said, this kingdom is going to stand. It's going to stand forever. Since this kingdom going to stand forever. Remember, Acts done told us. It says that, being known unto all and to all the people of Israel, and by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God had raised from the dead, even by him does this man stand here before you whole. This is the Lord's doing. This is the stone which was set in north of your building, which you become the head of the corner. Remember, he told us in Psalms chapter 1 and 18, verse 22 to 24. The stone which the builder refrained has become the head of the stone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, y'all, we ought to rejoice and be glad in it. It's tell us, therefore, truly saith the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion for a foundation, a dry stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. He that make haste shall not, he that believeth shall not make haste. Y'all, we're going to have to continue on with this. We got some more coming on pretty soon. I just want to get you to begin to realize the Lord Church is coming out of the city of Jerusalem. Back in AD 33, the church is coming out of the city of Jerusalem. We're going to see this as we continue on in our studying in God most holy in the divine word. We're going to see that this place that was prophesied in Isaiah, Daniel, and what Psalm talked about, we're going to see this church that when it been established, where it was, it did it come from? Jerusalem. Yes, sir. And we want to remember that it's in the last days when this going to take place. Number one, it's in the last days that where this going to take place. Number two, this place is the Lord's house is going to be established. The place in the last days that are going to be established is going to be the Lord's house. And in this house, it's going to be exalted above the hills. It's going to be exalted. It's going to be all over everything. It's going to be exalted above the hills. And when the Lord house come into being, into existence, what's going to happen? Remember, all nations will flow where? Unto it. Unto it. And when they get there, guess what? And many people, they're going to say, come ye, and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. They're going to the house of the God of Jacob. And what's going to happen when they get to the house of the God of Jacob? We saw this. And when they get there, they're going to be, when they get there, he's going to teach us of his ways. They're going to learn the ways of the Lord in his house, in his house. And when they learn the ways of his way, then they're gonna walk with him. And where is this gonna take place? Where the law of the Lord gonna begin? It said, out of Zion shall go forth the law. So the law is gonna go forth where? From Jerusalem. Then we saw that out of Zion. I lay in Zion for a foundation, a stone, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. So now we know that when this house come, it's gonna be a what? Sure foundation. It's gonna be a sure foundation. It, hallelujah, it's gonna be a sure foundation. It's gonna be sure. They're letting us know we don't even have to guess about it anymore, because it's sure. It is sure. It is a sure foundation, and this foundation will stand forever. And what should make us rejoice about this and what we just talked about is simply this. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. We ought to rejoice and be glad in this sure foundation. Then we find out that since this is a sure foundation, guess who did this? Guess who did this? Said this was the Lord's doing. Not yours, not mine, but this was the Lord's doing. The Lord laid this foundation. This, and he going to be the head or the corner of this foundation. Of this foundation. This is the Lord's doing. And man cannot change the order what the Lord have done. And then we saw in Acts chapter 4. In verse 10 to 12, it gave us a repeat what he said in Psalm chapter 118, verse 22 to 24. Gave us a repeat. Let us know this was the Lord's doing. But it got a little further in there. Since the Lord did this and he established this place, then he, for man to know that this is where you got to go, because it said only in his house that where you can learn of his ways. Now, if you go somewhere else, then he let us know in Acts to get a little bit more detail. If we go somewhere else, he let you know you can't go nowhere else, because he let us know that salvation not in another. Salvation nowhere else. Then we looked at Daniel chapter 2 and verse 4-4. We saw in Daniel chapter 2 and verse 4-4, it let us know that this house is not left in the hands of man. So man can't come in the house, the one we're talking about, AD 33, that was going to be established, that when it get here, man can't come and put his laws and rules and regulation in this house, because this is the Lord's doing. Lord have his house set up the way that he want to. And y'all, I hope that we continue on with our study. We just get into a little portion of the city of Jerusalem, AD 33. We're getting into AD 33. And I hope that as something that has been said as of this fall, that will cause you to think along the way. And remember, when we do the lesson, we're not trying to offend anyone. Only thing we're just trying to do, present the word of the Lord the way it is, without any addition or subtraction, because our job as being in members of the body of Christ, the church of Christ, is try to save as many souls as we possibly can. Let us bow. Our gracious and heavenly Father, the creator of both heaven and earth, Father, we thank you for the time we have had together in studying this lesson, getting into AD 33. We pray that it will open our hearts and mind and understanding of your most holy and divine word, so that we can be able to walk in your pathway and none other. We pray for those that in the church that have gone astray. Let them return back home before that last trumpet just sound. We pray for those that are not a member of the body of Christ. Open their hearts and minds up in your word. Give them the understanding so they may see as what your word says. For we know there are so many false prophets out in this world, causing many people's souls to be lost and just perverting your word all kind of way. But Lord, we pray that as we've been members of your body, the church that you gave your life for, that we can be able to be the light to the world, that the world might find Christ through us by the life we live, by the way we talk, by the way we sing, hallelujah, and by the way we pray. And by the way the preacher preach, and how that each member act in the body of Christ, that they will be a light to somebody to cause them to turn their life over to you. Come into this house, into the church that was established back in AD 33. Come into this house and learn your way and learn how to walk in your past. Come into your house and learn to be faithful unto death, and then we can receive a crown that will not fade away. This is how we pray in Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I hope you enjoyed the show, and please come back.